What up, what up?
Yeah, Bill Rapper View.
We back. We back. And you know, we definitely not having no more love songs, all right? Because I don't know why this man will recommend that, you know. Yeah, we just moving on, all right? But yeah, today we got my man. I've been wanting to do his songs for a while. This man, Reason. All the TDE, they have a crazy cam. Just like Dreamville, they got a crazy cam. And this man, Reason, he's like a loop to me almost, you know?
Okay.
He's like a loop to me. So yeah, we're going to get right into reviewing him. The song is Trapped In. It's actually featuring Absol and Boogie. But before we do, like, comment, subscribe, because I'm always forgetting to tell y'all beforehand. And y'all always forgetting. Y'all need to, like, lay off the stuff or something, because y'all forgetting. Click that button, all right? Let them know.
Yeah, we're going to start. You two talking too much, bro.
This for all my niggas trapped in. Caught a case and made me back spin. I've been focused bringing racks in. Yeah, dog Tennessee, the paws in it, trying to make it out like a saw. Make the bullets hit the whip and leave the car spinning. Niggas still pick the butterfly, I done flooded high and evolved in it. Niggas still on weird shit, got an issue, but don't never call niggas.
Little Henny made the road slide. I done ran up on a gold mine, Little Henny made the road slide. Cause I used to carry 4 or 5. I done seen a lot, done a lot. Dogs in it, see the paws in it. Trying to make it out like a saw victim. Bullets hit the whip, leave the car spinning. Niggas still pimp the butterfly. I done flooded high and evolved in it. He said they pimped the butterfly, but I still flutter high and evolved in it.
Yeah.
I still turn to the butterfly. You could still pimp me, but I'm still gonna, you know, turn to something beautiful. It's plays. Trying to make it out like a saw victim. Bullets hit the whip, leave the car spinning. Like, this man trying to make it out like a saw victim, you know, saw, you ain't making it out. You ain't making it out. You feel me?
Okay.
And then he follows that up with bullets hit the whip, leave the car spinning. So, you know, like he said, you a saw victim, you ain't making it out, bro.
Okay.
The bullets hit the whip, everybody gone, the car spinning.
Yeah.
And then he followed up with niggas still pimped the butterfly, done flooded high and evolved in it.
Mm.
You know, this man started out as a caterpillar and now, you know, he's becoming his own.
That brought me back to what's that thing called? To Pimp a Butterfly.
Yeah, that was
Kendrick's album too.
Yeah. Yep.
Seen a lot of niggas fall off. Come up missing like a call off. Reason was I never start off. Tie him up and take a ball off. Nigga picture, nigga bigger picture. I've been showing ass like I'm skinny dipping. Nigga flow tighter than a penny pitcher. Imagine if I got the henny with him. Imagine if a nigga sell drugs. Yeah, I sell drugs cause the flow crack. Imagine I could kill the whole world with the coke flow cause it's dope raps. I done a lot, seen a lot. Black skin, Filipino lives. This what happened when I dream a lot. Nigga dreams. This for all my niggas trapped in.
I just think that's a dope line. He's like, I done a lot, seen a lot, black skin feeling penalized.
Mm.
And I feel like that's just like a bar, you know. It could be going to the whole Pimp the Butterfly. It could be going to whatever. Just being someone with black skin, you always feel penalized just because you feel like, you know, there's more rules to the game than everybody else got, you know. So I feel like just that in itself and acknowledging, you know, that, you know, it is unfair for us because some people may not see it that way.
Mm-hmm.
I thought that was dope.
Caught a case and made me back spin. I've been focused bringing racks in. For my niggas on their own time. Remember thugging in my profile. Hey, I'd rather make it with my own guys. But I can't free them with a closed mind. Like, oh my, I pray this shit that I just twisted could get me about my shame. Put up on my homie bitch, he ain't tripped cause it ain't his main. Just saying, Lord, I know you see my pain. Help me while I find my hopes. Love you for your sense of humor. Don't tell me that my life a joke. I done hung with lions and bought the tickets from niggas woofing. I done seen a gun and just let them pull it and bit the bullet. I confront the ash of a fire past that my mom.
And one thing that's that I feel like we're not acknowledging too, and this is where the conversation of hypocrism is, like, I feel like should be put or should be brought in the conversation.
Yeah.
Because he says here, I done hung with lions and bought the tickets from niggas wolfing. I done seen the gun and just let him pull it and bit the bullet. And it's like he's saying he seen someone pull the trigger, but he didn't say nothing. He just took the visual for what it was and he just coped with it, whatever way he coped with it. But not, and it goes in the same way where, like, the person who took the video of the dude being kneed to the ground by police officers. Yeah. All these videos is like what he's saying there, and just saying he's seen the trigger pulled and he just bit the bullet. is what everyone has done. So it's like when we finally say it in our community, we're just saying it. No one's speaking on it. But when it's done outside of the community,
yeah,
now it's a problem. And that's like where like it's confusing for me, because this is the problem. The fact, you see what he just said. He's seen this shit.
But you gotta know that these problems stem because of
But that's what I mean. Like that's like the change. It's good to be mad when it happened outside, but the change ultimately, if we want to change that, let's start. We got to do it ourselves first. Let's start being more honest with each other, being more real with each other in a different way. And then that way could be better, I feel like. Or maybe we could have a chance at change from the outside if we could start to correct it on the inside. So that's where, like, it's all, I don't know. That line was just conflicting.
Yeah. I was putting, I created magic, how I got past it without me looking. Bragging ain't bragging, rapping, just rapping, you capping, your shit elastic, stretching it true till we factor in, shit ain't happen, I got this feel you can't fathom, I seen some shit you can't tap in, cause this what happened when you trapped in.
He says, I come from the ash of a fire, past that my mind was put in, I created magic, how I get it past without me looking. And again, that's like, it's dope because it's a reference to, obviously, Magic Johnson, and he's playing how, like, you know, Magic Johnson was known for being a playmaker, doing the no-look passes. Mm. And he's like, yo, I created magic. How I get past it without me looking? And that's reference to the no-look pass, so I just thought that was a strong
heavy that's bar dope. Right there. Yeah, that's dope. I want to just point out some of the stuff he said in the beginning. Like, he said, remember thugging in my profile? I'd rather make it with my own guys.
Mm-hmm.
But I can't free him with a closed mind. Like, oh my, I pray the shit that I just twisted could get me out my shame. Yeah. Slid up on my homie's bitch, he ain't tripped because it ain't his main.
Yeah.
Just saying, And, like, it goes back to, like, just being someone in that mindset of, like, he says, like, yo, I hope that, you know, this thing I rolled up could get me past the fact that I just slid up on my man's girl, mm-hmm. you know? Like,
and the thing I feel like was also should be appreciated in a sense is, you hear the context in which he's saying bitching. And when he's saying, like, a bitch, it's not necessarily that you're degrading a female, but it's the importance of that female to that one individual, which is his boy. The reason he's able to call her a bitch is because, like, it's not the fact that she's a bitch, but it's just the fact that to him, she's just this girl that he just uses whenever he just wants to get, like, you know, his little rub off or something like that. So I think that's something that very, that's like just a
what
key
work
factor.
You put into the female is what you see them as.
Yeah. So
if you don't see no worth in them, then you're probably gonna see them.
And
as
that's
that.
The context in which he's using bitching. So I feel that should be like very, that should be noted out. And two, just to end the verse, I thought the way he ended that shit was strong. Where he was like, rapping, just rapping, you capping, your shit elastic, stretching the truth till we factor in shit
ain't
happen. I got this feel you can't fathom. I seen some shit you can't tap in, because this will happen when you...
And he, trapped in.
You know, yeah, and it's like, yo, I just think that was dope. It's just the fact that he's calling out people. He's saying, nah, like, I can speak on some things I know you can't, you know, you can't bear to talk about. That shit will make you sick because I lived it, you haven't. And that's being real with it. And the people ask, what's the difference between this kind of rap and that kind of rap? That's the difference, is clearly what he just stated, so...
Yeah, he also kind of goes into, like, his verse kind of goes into the hook, you know, now that I'm thinking about it, because he's saying he's trapped in, and it could be just trapped in mentally, and, you know, he's making all these decisions because he feels trapped in because of his, like, surroundings or his situation.
Yeah.
You know, like, you bragging ain't bracking, you know? It also goes into, like, the first line he says, like, you'd be saying the first line is important, where he just says, I'd rather make it with my own guys, but I can't free him with a closed mind, you know? And I think that's one of his strongest lines
there.
That's
a thesis right there, bro. That's a thesis. The first line is always ends up becoming the thesis. So.
You can't free him with a closed mind, you know?
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah. I think next verse is Absol. That was Boogie. And then we'll see how it closes out. Yeah, caught a case of maybe back spin. I've been focused bringing racks in.
This for all my niggas trapped in. Matt, all things fall apart, everything goes south. Homie had the most heart, he a deadbeat now. Stuck in the mud, man, we need to put the scissor down. Life ain't quite the picnic when the chips are down. Look,
most of the niggas I pictured as winners just went away. I had to get up and make a way. I need the whole planet to know my name. Mama said, don't quit your day job. I was a second from selling yay. I needed a deal like playing cards. Made a few records for Soundwave. Whoever swallowed the key to the cage that we stay in, I make them regurgitate it. One time I heard I was underrated. I'd rather that than us getting raided. Ay, anxious under invested. investigate.
Look, most of the niggas I pictured as winners just went away. Mm. And what I love about this is his experience. He helped people to a certain extent growing up, and now to, you know, when everyone's conscious at a certain point, when everything becomes equal, these people took a different route.
Or it's just like, you know, you see people as great when you're in the same surroundings as them, but once you get past them, you're like, you know, everything wasn't as great as it seemed, you know?
And I feel like because it all becomes at a point where, like, you know, we had assistance at a certain point. Now we need to make our way. And that point when we do, when it is time for us to make our way, and that's when the switch up.
Yeah.
And that's when he
says, that's when you see everyone go there. Go
some people stuck in the mud. They're still stuck in that mentality. Like, they, you know, they got
they still doing drugs. You know, they need to put the scissor down.
Like, they haven't, like, realized that they're in control. They got the key. And that's what the even that line where he's like, most of the niggas I pictured as winners just went away. I had to get up and make a way. I need the whole planet to know my name. Mama said, don't quit your day job. I was second from selling yay. I needed a deal like playing cards.
And what I like about this is that, I don't know if he meant to do like this play on words, but before he was a rapper, he was working, his 9-to-5 was working at a record shop that his family owned. And I like how he says, Mama said, don't quit your day job. I was a second from selling yay.
Yeah.
And I feel like that's being like, I was a second from selling a Kanye tape, but instead I went and, you know, made my own tape.
Okay, yeah.
You know, I could have still been in that record shop, and I could have been to the point where I'm selling Kanye.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
But, you know, I made it out. So I thought that was dope. And it's also like selling yay, like selling.
And after he said that, he's like, I needed a deal, like playing cards. Yeah, that's fun. And then he also goes on to say, whoever swallowed the key to the cage that we stay in, I'll make him regurgitate it. And that's what I mean, where, like, we all come to that point where we're assisted in life for so long to the point where it's time for us to take the key back, and now we need to make a way.
Yeah. And if someone's trying to stop us from getting to where we are, we're gonna force the key out, you know?
But the most important part is that he wanted the key back. So many people get stuck because they're never even aware that they have a key.
Yeah, and that there is a key
and
there.
That's the saddest part. Yeah. That's the saddest part is when you don't know that you're in possession of your key if you want it. So.
Yeah.
I think that was dope. And just the whole mindset, again, to get to that point to write this, that's what's like so impressive for me. And that's what, like, you know, that's the respect I have. That's like where the tip to the, you know, the hat tip comes into play. Cause
no, absolutely. Like definitely. He's one of my favorite, like, lyricists. This man said, one time I heard I was underrated. I'd rather that than getting rated.
Yeah. And then again, that's the whole perspective.
You're doing better than people thought you would.
It's progression as well.
I done seen a lot, niggas done a lot. In cars and dodging the sheriff station, went broke bailing my brother. That's all to a Mac. Had to send me sweets. Or a fiend on Halloween till it's a wrap like an Easter basket. My collard greens with plenty season. A solution and a reason. There you have it.
Yep, that's Trapped In by the man Reason. The man Reason, Abso, and Boogie. Boogie was the second on it. Mm. Abso was the third. You know, got three eyes, feel me? But, I thought this song was fire.
Yeah, no, it was a good song.
And they all tied in, like, well, like, the concept I felt like was just trapped in. Like, you know, it could be trapped in mentally, trapped in your surroundings. And they're talking about their experience and, you know, either how they got out of being trapped in or just the mindset they had to, like, get out of that, you know?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I fuck with each...
all of them were dope in their own way. Yeah.
And respectively, all of them just, I feel like the biggest point I can take from each of them is that they took control.
Yeah.
From each verse, like, they're talking from a point of view where they didn't let anyone take control of their path. Evidently, they said, fuck it, I'm going to just do it. And that's and that's the point we all need to get to. And I think that's what's so great about this message and just rap songs in general. It's evidence that when you take control, you know,
things are possible.
Yeah,
for
things
real.
Are possible. So, like, don't spend time thinking. Don't spend time, like, fuck, I'm going to be so down.
Or don't spend time caring about others' opinions or seeing where others around you are. Like, damn, I'm not going to be able to become a crazy rapper because the dopest rapper in my hood lives across the street from me and he ain't doing nothing, you know?
It just started.
You gotta have that mentality where you know you can elevate it. Yeah.
Just start. And along the way, when you do start and people see that you're invested in what you want to do, people will help you as long as you believe in what you're doing.
Like, and as long as they believe in what you're doing. You know, I feel like, well, all three of them, they just made their message stronger, you know? And that's the power in it, you know? It's like, you know, you could either be the person who brings someone down and try and outshine them, or, you know, you could make something collective, you know?
And like Reason said in the beginning, he was like, I done a lot, seen a lot, black skin, feeling penalized. It's what happens when I dream a lot, nigga dreams. But now I feel like he says, I done a lot, I done seen a lot. And then somebody else said, like, stretching the truth till we factor and shit ain't happen. I got this feel you can't fathom. I seen some shit you can't tap in, because this is what happens when you... But and what I love is the fact that they're all on the same record, and the fact that they're able to speak on the same record, because all of them could relate to what they're speaking
exactly,
on.
Exactly,
and that's what he's saying. Like, he's like, yo, if y'all ain't real, like, these other two dudes I'm on this track with, if y'all can't share the same experience, if you can't, you know, if you can't share that same picture, then, like, nah, like, we can't have this conversation.
And the dope,
like,
part is that this. While the picture is the same for them, all their perspective is different.
They're different, you know? Exactly.
And that's what makes it dope, you know? They could all grow up in Cali. I don't think all of them are from Cali, but this is just speaking hypothetically. They could all grow up in Cali and still have, you know, something very unique about each
one of them. For sure. But overall, I love this song, man. I'll give it like a 9 out of 10. But it was
definitely
dope.
Up there,
Classic hip hop, and it just, especially
for even from time, the beat, from the beginning. Like, you don't even have to hear a word yet, and you just like, word.
And there was no wasted bar. It was like, boom. They already knew. They sat with it. And, you know, everything was marinated in terms of how they're going to approach it, how they're going to attack it. And they just attacked it. They stopped thinking and just went for it. So,
the one criticism I would have is probably just the hook or the chorus. I felt like it could have just been a little more engaging. Just not trapped in. But as you, like, listen to the song, like, it really, like, leaves the foundation. Like, that's what the song is about, you know? So, for that, I appreciate it. I feel like it could have been just a little more engaging. But for the purpose of it, it did its purpose.
Right. But, yeah, man, that's some...
Dope beat. Dope song.
Reason, Trapped In. And is it an awful album or not?
I don't think it's... Not an album that's out yet that I know of. I think you should be looking out for an album for Reason, though. Don't be trapped in, yo. Don't be trapped in. Get out that box and, you know, start clicking on these links.
This brother's back, man. On the last video, he was colonized. You feel me? But he came back on this one. You feel me? He came back on this one. So, you know what it is, though. Real rap and view, your boy, down with you.
Call me Hova Hefe.
Oh, you already know the Reverend, man. We out.